Hey guys, I'm Pineapple Brain. Today we are going to check out the mod IO particle system, and in my game I implement them, and as you can see here, when a monster get attacked, they will have some effects nearby them, and when I hit on the resources, there are some as well. So we are in the testing game, and we can shoot some bullets and they will produce us some effects. And when we fire some items, we can also use the particles. So this particle system is very useful, and today we are going to know the settings of it one by one. So we will make use of this stick item, and we will go into the script of it to see the emit particle script. So here we got the script, and when we use it, we will create some particles. So there are two types of actions that we can create particles at the moment. The one is emit particle at position, and another one is emit particles from entity. So both of it, we need to provide the particle type and the phasing angle in degree. So it is important that it is in degree, and if the value that you get is a radian, for example here, I used the phasing angle in radian, and we will need to convert it to degree. Also, we will pass the entity or a position to this particle emitter action, and we can emit some particle. So here we will create particle, new particle, facing the facing angle of the unit that holding this item from this item. So this is what the stick. So here you will see that it will spawn some tiny rockets here, but it is too small. And today we will customize it here. We go to the global variable, go to the enumerations and particles, and go to the new particles here. And I already have some image here, and you can upload your own, and we can have the exact index like other unit items, projectiles, and usually 5 is higher than other unit and items, and normally unit will have 3 and item will have 4, so 5 is higher than them generally. And for the life base, it will determine how many milliseconds each particle will last before they are disappearing. So if you increase the value, so this is milliseconds, so for example I want 3 seconds, I change like this, and it will last for 3 seconds, these tiny rockets, and before they despawn, they will last for 3 seconds. And if you change the depth opacity base, so this will control the opacity of them before they despawn. So the closer to the lifespan of them, the lower opacity they are. If you change this value, the maximum of it is 1 and the minimum of it is 0. 0 means totally transparent, and 1 means totally not transparent. And you can set this value to some decimal place, maybe 0.5 or something, but I will choose to set it 0. And you can see the effect that they are fading out when their life is expired. And here, the dimension control the width and the height of it. If you change the width to 32 and the height to 4, you will see the difference that it is very wide, but seems that now you can not change the dimension, width and height together, but instead you can only make it scale to the original image size. So here, maybe we can just make it smaller. So 16 to 16, we will change it to 16 to 16. So it will have something like this spawning around. And then for the emit zone, so the default value is 0 and 0, which means it is the exact location, the center. This is a zone. it is a rectangular zone, and the position or the entity you provided in the script is the center of this emit zone, and this x and y value determine the width and the height of the zone. So if you set this one to 50, which means the zone with a width of 50, so 25 to the left, 25 to the right, and this zone is not rotatable and it is always a square that facing up. So the x is 50, and maybe we can try, but it will not work because it will appear like this. No, nothing changed because the y value, the emit zone y, we set it to 0, it would disable the total emit zone, it will disable it. So we will need to change it to a non-zero y value in order to make a emit zone that only relies on x, so we can see the difference. So you will see that we got an emit zone with a width of 50 and a height of 1. So you can increase the y value as well, maybe 1000, then the zone is very big and you see that many of the particles from the top to down. So randomly we will have something like this, and then let's disable this at this moment. We change them back to 0 and go to the duration and the emit frequency. The duration will determine how long they keep spawning these projectiles when you start execute it by an action. So this one, the default is 100, and if we change it to 5000, which means 5 seconds, when I press it once, it will keep spawning for 5 seconds and then stop. So this one determines the duration. And then the emit frequency. So emit frequency means that in this duration, how frequent it will spawn. So if you type 10 here, it means that every 10 milliseconds it will spawn a new one. So if you increase the value to 500, it will spawn fewer. You will see that it spawned fewer, like 10 missile only, around 10 missile only. So if you increase the value, it will lower the frequency, and if you make it to 1, it will keep spawning every 1 milliseconds, or you can treat it keep spawning very much until the duration expired, but we don't want them to do so. So if we increase back to 5, and the duration will lower back to 300. So we will see the effect again, and it will stop like this. So here, for the angle, speed, and fix the rotation, we will first introduce the speed first. The speed will apply to the angle that you given here plus this angle. So the angle here, we don't set it yet because we'll introduce it later, but the angle that you provide will be inherited here. The 0, 0 here means that the angle that you provide, so it is a relative angle. So if you change the speed here first, we're not gonna introduce angle now. We change the speed first. If we increase the speed, then you will see that the particles are shooting faster. And for here, we have minimum and maximum value. And if you change maximum value, it will randomly get a speed and then shoot it. So we will have something like this. Some of them is faster, some of them is slower. And then here, if you fix their rotation, then the sprite is always up, no matter what angle they are shooting to. They were always up and no rotation. So this depends, and I will turn it off. And finally, for the angle here, the minimum and maximum value are the degrees, same as the script. So it determines the angle, the random angle that spawns. So if you type 0, it will straightforward go to the angle that you've given. But if you type something here, maybe here, we can type something like 0 to 90. You will see that they randomly spawn at the angle of 0, which is the top, and 90 degree, which is the left. And actually, there is something we can change here. So actually, we don't use the angle from 0 to 360, because our unit, we normally want them to spawn left and right. So we use the logic that left and right equals to negative and positive. So we will have the range maximum. The minimum value of this range is negative and 180. Maximum is 180. So if you do so, negative and 180 and 180, then it will spawn around. So all angles are covered relative to your item's angle. And if you don't want it, you want to lower the area, lower the angle that shoot. So if you lower to 45 and 45 here, negative 45 and 45, this is a range, and you will get a total angle of 90 degree with 45 degree towards left and 45 degree towards right. So we got something like this shooting around, and you can customize your angle as well here. So if I only want to shoot at a certain angle, then minimum value equals to the maximum value. So if I just want them shooting to the left relative to their facing angle, set it in the script, then I would just set the minimum equals to the maximum, and then it will always shoot at the same angle like this. So here you are already able to utilize all of these settings inside the particles, and now you can customize them. That's all of this video. If you like it, don't forget to share and subscribe my YouTube channel. See you in the next video. Bye bye.